So why I don't advise my students to work in SOC? Here's the thing. SOC is a really important job. It's very critical to any organization. It's really important to be there. And there's so many people made for that job. They really want this job and that's their passion. But here's the thing. If you want more in your career, more than just SOC, wants to work in incident response, in digital forensics, and as a digital investigator, as a malware analyst, as a threat hunter, as a doing purple team, doing red team, whatever you want to work beyond the SOC, SOC is not your best start for your career. And here's the thing. In SOC, when you work in SOC, to advance to the next level, you need to learn so many things. You invest a lot in learning and improving your skills, but in the wrong direction. Most of what you learn when you work in SOC is how to use different products from Trend Micro, from Sophos, from IBM QRadar, from Juniper, Cisco, whatever the products are. You learn more how to use these products and how to configure these products and how to maintain these products and how to look for issues in these products. You mostly learn how to use. You become a user of different companies and vendors' products. You don't learn how these products actually work, what they are protecting you from, and how the real attacks actually look like. There is, of course, a level of investment in your learning in this direction, but I would say 70% on how the products work and 30% on how actually incident response or cybersecurity work, how the real attacks work, and how these tools actually work. And continuing in that direction, you will just become a user of all of these different products. You will not be able to advance to really understand how an incident response from a holistic view looks like. And I see that a lot of time. The truth is, the attacker doesn't care about what products and what vendor you are using. He knows his techniques and his tactics, and he knows how he can bypass all of these different products, how he can bypass the security controls, how he can bypass all the log collection, all the alerts. He can actually bypass your EDR products, your antivirus, your IDS, IBS firewalls. He can bypass all of these products, and he has the techniques that works with most of these vendors. And for you to really understand to work in incident response and become competent in such jobs, you need to understand how the attacker actually plan his attack, how he executes his attack, and how he bypass all the security controls, how he bypass detection, how you can improve your detection. So if you are building your career in cybersecurity and you want to work, your passion is about incident response or digital forensics or malware analysis or digital investigation, then skip the SOC part. Don't waste your time in the SOC. Don't waste your time learning about different products and different vendors. But focus on learning how the real attacks look like, how target ransomware looks like, how EBT attacks look like, and how you can actually protect against these attacks. Not how each Trend Micro product or Sophos product work, but how this like what do you actually how they can you can use them, but more how they actually all of these products work and how they can integrate into the whole plan to secure your organizations against these attacks. This is my advice to you. If you are looking for these jobs, then move beyond the SOC analyst and directly target the jobs and the positions you are passionate about and you want to work for. Directly learn what's important for incident response and malware analysis and digital forensics, and directly apply for these jobs. See you in the next video. Bye bye.